Hi, it's Mark Davis from markdavispianomusic.com. How's everybody doing? Happy Labor Day weekend, everyone. Hope everybody's enjoying themselves. The weather's supposed to be terrific this weekend, so enjoy. I'm going to do stuff from 1964 tonight. It's a top 10 from 1964. And last Monday, I had my friend Tom come by. I hope everybody got to check him out. I'm going to plan on having him come back again sometime soon, and it should be fun. And I want everybody to go to flowpage.com/Mark Davis Piano Music, and you can go to all my links from there. And I'd love to get everybody to share tonight. That would be terrific if you guys could do that for me. And I got a few surprises in store, and the first one is going to be a special guest star on my stereo, who I'm going to play along with. So this is Laura James and Excel, including me. And this is the other band I was in, not The View, but this is Excel with John Vario and Laura James on the vocals. And this is a song by Martha Reeves and the Mandellas. And let's see if I can get this to work for everybody. So that was Laura James and me in Excel quite a few years ago. It was before my son was born, so about 28 years old. Pretty good, huh? My son's birthday was the 3rd of September. And happy birthday, Scott. Tatiana for all the help over the weeks and through the months, and they're here again tonight helping me out. And I want to help my gonna say a big shout out to my wife too for helping out with other things behind the scenes. Really appreciate it. And so that was Martha Reeves and the Vandellas that did that song originally. It was Dancing in the Streets, and she also did the song Heat Wave, and she did Quicksand, and what was the other one she did? Jimmy Mac and Nowhere to Run, Nowhere to Hide. And the next thing I'm going to do is something by the Drifters. And this is Under the Boardwalk. And originally Benny King came from the Drifters. And this is Under the Boardwalk. Thank you. Drifters, that was on Broadway, and before that was Under the Boardwalk. And Under the Boardwalk was in 1964, in September. This is the countdown we're doing tonight from September 1964. And next song is gonna be, oh, it's by one of my favorites. This is by the Beatles. This is A Hard Day's Night. Day's Night by the Beatles. That went gold. And here's another one by them from the same era. This is from A Hard Day's Night too. Thank you. That's the Beatles again. That's I Love Her and I Love Her. And that's also from A Hard Day's Night. Thanks everybody for sticking around tonight and listening to what's going on. I appreciate it. And I want to thank everyone for the support they've given me all through this coronavirus thing going on. And hope everybody tunes in again next week. I'll have another show for you next week. Tonight we're going to have a TV theme. I might have two for you tonight because it's Labor Day. It might be interesting. I have one that's kind of easy and one I'm a little bit tougher. So we'll do that a little later on. And I'm going to continue with the countdown. I just want to do one thing right now. I want to open the piano up for a second. Hold on 1 second. I'm back. Sorry. I can't do Kitten on the Keys tonight because the cat's upstairs. Yeah, he's up with, she's up there with Scott and Tatiana and Pat. So I'm going to do another song right now. It's from the British Invasion also. It was from Jerry and the Pacemakers. And Jerry Marsden and his brother, I forget what his name was, but the drummer was his brother. And they had a lot of hits from the Mersey Beat. They did things like Ferry Cross the Mersey, Don't Let the Sun Catch You Crying. And they did this other song, it's called How Do You Do? And How Do You Do It? And it was originally supposed to be given to the Beatles to do, but they didn't want to do it. So it was given to Jerry and the Pacemakers to do. So this is How Do I Do It? How Do You Do It? Son came home and fixed it. Thank goodness. So everything's fine now. Next song is a song by, let's see, this one is by the Supremes, and this is Where Did I Love Go? And this song didn't go to the gold, but the following song went gold. The following song was Baby Love. So this for it, and this is Where Did I Love You? did I Love Go by The Supremes. Before it was Diana Ross and The Supremes, of course. The next song I'm going to do is a song by The New Beats. Has anyone heard of The New Beats? They had one hit song, and I was very confused by it. I'm sure everybody else was. It's a song called Bread and Butter, and I always thought it was a girl singing that part. You know, I always liked bread and butter, and I used to love toast and jam. But it wasn't a girl singing it. It was a guy singing it. I couldn't believe it. I looked it up. It's a guy from Texas singing it. And insane. It sounds just like a woman singing it. So this is... That's Bread and Butter, and that was by The New Beats, and I'm going to do another one right now for you, and this is kind of related. I'll tell you in a minute why, okay? So this is one people have requested of me to play before, so you get an extra bonus tonight with this one. Thank you. people are trying to figure out what the hell I'm doing. And I'll tell you, the song Wind Beneath My Wings was co-written by this gentleman from the New Beats, the lead singer, Larry Henley. He helped write that song, Wind Beneath My Wings. So he sort of redeemed himself after he sang like a woman, I guess. You know, so I don't know. Kind of weird. If you listen to that song, you'll know what I'm talking about. It's bread and butter. So the next song I'm going to do is a song. This song is by the Shangri-Las. Does anyone remember the Shangri-Las? The Shangri-Las were the group that did a lot of songs, like they did You Can Never Go Home Anymore, and then they did Give Him a Great Big Kiss, Mwah! And what else did they do? They also did Leader of the Pack. And this other song, pretty familiar to everyone, I'm sure, especially if you go to the beach. And this is a song that somebody wrote for them to record. It was the first song they ever recorded, and the guy went to the beach to figure this song out, and the seagulls were in the background, and he decided he'd sing it, he'd do this song. So this is Walking in the Sand. So this is, and also the person playing the chords at the very beginning of the song, it was kind of a famous guy, but he wasn't famous at all at the time. It was Billy Joel. He was playing the chords on this song, and he never got paid for it. So that's Walking in the Sand. So this is it. Stephen Tyler did it with Aerosmith at one point, in case you were wondering. They did that song too. Yeah, this is a nice, pretty song I'm going to do next. This song right now is another one from the British Invasion. It's from a band that was around the same time as the Beatles. They were in competition with the Beatles. They had a song called Can't You See That She's Mine, and that was the A side of the song. The B side of the song was Because, and they didn't think, people in the recording industry didn't think it was going to go anywhere, but it went way away. It went way far, and they did really well with it, and it was written by Dave Clark and Mike Smith, the lead singer from Dave Clark 5, and this is Because.
Thank you.
Clark Five also, and before that, Because by the Dave Clark Five. We just got a request, did we? I don't know if I can do that. We'll see what we can do. It's for John and Priscilla. And let me see if I can still find it here. Hold on. Let's see if I can still do it. Is the number two song. This was number two on that week in 64. This is sung by Dean Martin. Thank you. record for Dean Martin, and that was number two. And this is number one. This was a group called The Animals with Eric Verdon, and they had many hits. This was their very first hit. It was The House of the Rising Sun, and they also did Don't Let Me Be Misunderstood. They did We Gotta Get Out of This Place, It's My Life, CeCe Ryder, Help Me Girl, When I Was Young, San Francisco Nights, Monterey, and Sky Pilot. The bass player was Chaz Chandler. He ended up managing kind of a popular guitar player. He was pretty good in his day. It was Jimi Hendrix, and so he managed him till he died. So this song is The House of the Rising Sun. Scott, come here for a minute. Come over here. This is my son, Scott. Come into the camera for a second. Say hi to everybody. Hi. This is the birthday boy. His birthday was this week. Everybody wish him a happy birthday tonight, related. And Scott's been helping me with the board. Show the board you've been showing me. This is the board he uses behind the scenes when somebody makes a request. I can't see it on the camera here, but he sees it upstairs, and that's how I get all the requests. So I'm going to do the next request. It's for Cynthia, and I hope she's having a wonderful weekend, long weekend. Thanks, Scott. And I'm going to do What a Wonderful World for her. Anyone else would like to hear it? So... Thank you. That's a Wonderful World. Thank you for the request. 2 weeks ago, well, 3 weeks ago, we had about 70 shares happening on the broadcast. If you guys could help share this week, we'd really appreciate it. This past Wednesday, we had reached 1,000 followers. We're more than that. We're over 1,060 now. I want to thank everyone for the support on that, too. And for everyone, including the new folks, tell me where you're listening from. And I'd like to hear about that, especially new people that are coming in. And please go to flowpage.com/MarkDavisPianoMusic, and that will link you up to all of my different links. Also, at my website, it's www.markdavispianomusic.com. Put you on my mailing list, and we'll put out another mailing next week, I hope. And right now, I'm going to do a couple more songs for you guys. Next thing I'm going to do is, I think we'll do one of the TV requests right now. Because it's getting kind of late. And I hope everybody's having a wonderful Labor Day weekend. I hear footsteps. Somebody's coming down. Somebody's coming to see me. I don't know who it is. We'll see. I think it's Scott again. We'll see. What's going on? Oh, we got 1,094 followers today. Thank you so much. And what do we got? Young by Adele. I don't think I know that one, but it's requested by Rebecca. I will try and get that for you for next time. I can do another song by Adele. This song is Make You Feel My Love, which I really like. It was written by Bob Dylan, and Brian Ferry did a great version of it too. So this is Make You Feel My Love. To my TV song yet. I'm going to do that for you right now, and this is the easier one of the two, so let's see how you do on this one. This was a popular song during the 60s and early 70s, I guess. So see if you can guess this one. Someone else right now. I found out it was his birthday today. Chuck, happy birthday, Chuck, my friend Chuck. Scott's here again. He's doing something. I have one more birthday to give. My brother Richard, was his birthday. It was the same day as my son Scott's, and I got to do happy birthday to Richard too. Another birthday out of the way. So I hope I got everybody. I don't know if I got everybody. Hope so. So I'm wondering how many people got that song on the TV theme. Scott, do you know how many people got the TV theme happening? Or are they still guessing at it? I'm going to do another song. This is by William Joel. This is... Honesty. Thank you. got the whiteboard down here again. Congratulations to Diane, Judy, Peter, and Priscilla. They all got it correct. That was the theme from the Monkees. And they were the television equal to the Beatles. That's where they came from. I have another song for you right now. I'm going to do one more TV theme. See if anybody knows this one. This one's going to be kind of a little tougher, a little bit off the wall. So see if anybody can get this one. This is for Labor Day. This is the Rainbow Connection. Oh my God. nobody got that song. That was the theme from Twin Peaks. Damn good cup of coffee I had there. So that was the Twin Peaks theme. Nobody knew that one. Well, that would stump the whole crew, yeah. Next week we'll have something else for you. I'll have something that people will know, okay? So I'm going to end it with a couple more songs. And I want to thank everybody for listening tonight. And please have everybody share this with everyone they know. I would really appreciate it. And please go to fullpage.com/MarkDavisPianoMusic. And you can see all my links from there. And go to my website. It's www.markdavispianomusic.com. And if you have any kind of bookings coming up, let me know. If you're interested in having me play the piano somewhere. Been doing a lot of assisted living places outside right now, and hopefully we get more going, and we'll see what happens. The song is That Old Black Magic. One more for everybody. This is Honeysuckle Rose. Thank you. everybody. Everybody have a great Labor Day weekend, and I'll see you next week. Thanks so much.